divided into rich and poor as at no time in our history. The richest 2% own more than half the household wealth in the world. The richest 10% hold 85% of total global assets, and the bottom half of humanity owns less than 1% of the wealth in the world. The three richest men in the world have more money than the poorest 48 countries. Fact. While those responsible for the 2008 global financial crisis were bailed out and even rewarded by the G20 governments gathering here, the International Labor Organization tells us that in 2009, 34 million people were added to the global unemployed, swelling those ranks to 239 million, the highest ever recorded. Another 200 million are at risk in precarious jobs, and the World Bank tells us that at the end of 2010, another 64 million will have lost their jobs. By 2030, more than half the population of the megacities of the global south will be slum dwellers with no access to education, healthcare, water, or sanitation. Fact. Global climate change is rapidly advancing, claiming at least 300,000 lives and $125 billion in damages every year. Called the silent crisis, climate change is melting glaciers, eroding soil, causing freak and increasingly wild storms, displacing untold millions from rural communities to live in desperate poverty in peri-urban centers. Almost every victim lives in the global south, in communities not responsible for greenhouse gas emissions and not represented here at this summit. The atmosphere has already warmed up a full degree in the last several decades, and is on course to warm up another 2 degrees by 2100. Fact, half the tropical forests in the world, the lungs of our ecosystem, are gone. By 2030, at a present rate of extraction or so-called harvest, only 10% will be left standing. 90% of the big fish in the sea are gone, victim to wanton predatory fishing practices. Says a prominent scientist studying their demise, there is no blue frontier left. Half the world's wetlands, the kidneys of our ecosystem, have been destroyed in the 20th century. Species extinction is taking place at a rate 1,000 times greater than before humans existed. According to a Smithsonian science, we will be destroyed at a rate faster than nature can replace them with new ones. Fact, we are polluting our lakes, rivers, and streams to death. Every day, 2 million tons of sewage and industrial agriculture waste are discharged into the world's water. That's the equivalent of the entire human population of 6.8 billion people. The amount of wastewater produced annually is about 6 times more water than exists in all the rivers of the world. We are mining our groundwater faster than we can replenish it, sucking it to grow water-guzzling, chemical-fed crops in deserts, or to water thirsty cities who dump an astounding 700 trillion liters of land-based water into oceans every year as waste. The global mining industry sucks up another 800 trillion liters, which it also leaves behind as poison, and fully one-third of global water withdrawals are now used to produce biofuels, enough water to feed the world. Nearly 3 billion people on our planet do not have running water within a kilometer of their home. And every 8 seconds, somewhere in our world, a child is dying of waterborne disease. The global water crisis is getting steadily worse, with reports of countries from India to Pakistan to Yemen facing depletion. The World Bank says that by 2030, demand for water will outstrip supply by 40%. This may sound just like a statistic, but the suffering behind that is absolutely unspeakable. Fact, knowing there will not be enough food and water for all in the near near future, wealthy countries and global investment, pension, and hedge funds are buying up land and water, fields and forests in the global south, creating a new wave of invasive colonialism that will have huge geopolitical ramifications. Rich countries faced by food shortages have already bought up an area in Africa alone more than twice the size of the United Kingdom. Now, I don't think I exaggerate if I say that our world has never faced a greater set of threats and issues than it does today. So what are the 20 leaders who have gathered here, some already here and the others coming in tonight, what are they going to talk about over the next 2 days? And by the way, their summit costs $1 million a minute. And by the way, we figure that it's going to be closer to $2 billion when it's finished, and the annual budget to run the United Nations is $1.9 billion. I assure you, they are not going to tackle the above issues in any serious way. The declarations have already been drafted, the failures already spun. Instead, this global royalty, who have more in common with one another than they do with their own citizens, and are here really to advance the issues and interests of their class, are also here just to advance the status quo that serves the interests of the elite in their own countries and the business community, or the B20, the new term, community that will get private and privileged access to advance their free market solutions to these eager leaders.